statins, seeing when the moment it's going to break. And these behaviors, I mean, again, you're taking all these patterns, and you, if you want to see how people behave literally and how they express these opinions in the market, you can see something like this. I mean, we're talking about the Swiss now, but from last week you've seen the pound Swiss. That was the buy about the 20 breakout. So that's the pound coming in. If you look at the pound yen, that was with the, look at the pound yen. Now it's beginning to come above the structure. Look at the euro yen. Now it is, again, the euro is weaker. It hasn't manifested itself that much, but at least you got the last 4 days of the week. It is pushing up for the last 4 days of the week. If you look at the dollar yen, again, it's the upside down. Look at this. It is the upside down diamond that you've seen on the index. And if you look at the Aussie, it's beginning to get positive, but yet, and that diamond is going to break. And now you're going to get this bear market, if you will, in the Japanese yen. When the dollar, when the Aussie yen gets above the structure point, when the dollar gets above the structure point, the pound is the first one that came above the structure. Right now, that's the first one that came above the structure. So now it's, they're beginning to compile it. And that's why you get this triangle. Now the pound yen is getting stronger. It's going to be followed by, let's say, the dollar yen, then the Aussie yen, then the Japanese yen. And once they all get above the structure, you're going to get the break in the yen index. Okay? So we need to prepare the new turtles now. That's a good setup, because you can take the Japanese index on a break. Okay? So let's first start with, as I said, with the dollar Swiss. And as you see on the, let me put the daily, the weekly dollar Swiss, looking at the, that chart on a weekly base, this is closing the week at 92.64. That is a fantastic close, even with all the selling of that came in into the Aussie, into the dollar, I mean, last week. We're having such a fantastic close. And right here, when we have this, I'm just going to move this to the other side. Oh, that's wrong. If you look at our close this week, we closed the week at 92.64, and we had the breakout of the structure at 96. So we did break, I'm sorry about the 92. We broke above the 92, and now we close 60 points higher, and the next structure point is the 93. I just want to see what the 93 is. Just trying to see where the 93 is, so at least I can get my bearing. Yeah, this is the 93, was the low of 2011. Okay, so let's go back to our regular scale. So this is the 93 over here, and it was this. Okay, so you got this as a low, and now it is a resistance point. So now, again, a break above the And this two here, guys, I want you to see this. This is a fantastically positive setup. This is a classic positive setup. Why? Because we have a structure point at 93. We did break above the 93 on Thursday. We sold off after the break as an indication that this is not as an important point, not a structure point, or there was a lot of resistance and they sold it. But that selling stopped and we reversed back on Friday. That is as good as a positive signal that you can get. When you fail, it's a failure trade. When you fail to break above, instead of getting capitulation, you're getting recuperating of strength, and now it is closing pretty much at near the high of the day, and the high was 87, closing at 64. This is a very positive setup, and that is a very good indication that the first thing we have to do, we need to be buying the Aussie, I'm sorry, the dollar Swiss. So let's find our structure point above that, which is the 93. Okay, so that is our structure point, the 93. We did close at 92, we tested the 92.80. Well, we can buy it above, so we're going to set up the dollar Swiss. So our buying point on the dollar Swiss is going to be the 92.80. As soon as it gets out of this high, and our structure pull long point is the 93 as last week. And if I'm buying it above 92.80, I'm going to place my stop right below these two daily highs, which is my long stop is going to be 92.40, and I really don't see any reason for us to take it to the short side unless it takes that structure point which we had, which is the 92.01, the 92.01 here. So this is going to be our short point and our structural short. And it is also going to be our stop. And we're doing this in order to be consistent. Some of you asked, well, I mean, it can't be the same stop. You just have to be a little bit reasonable. Give it a few pips on either side of the trade, okay? So, for the dollar Swiss, we are going to be buyers of the dollar Swiss on a trade above the 92.80. Your structure point is the 93. You're looking for an explosive move above of that, and if you buy it at 92.80, you're going to place your stop below 92.40. So you're risking about 40 pips on that trade. On the short side for the dollar Swiss, you will only go short on a trade below the structure point, which is the 92.01, and that will be your short point, your structure short, and your stop. Okay, that is the dollar Swiss. I'm going to save the recording.